Welcome back. This is The Circle Live. Our next guest is a multi-talented woman. She's an actress and entrepreneur who is adding yet another title to her list of accolades, executive producer.
That's right. She's the EP of the new BET movie, Hip Hop Hollywood. You might see a familiar face in this clip.
Yes.
Hip Hop Holiday.
There you go.
How about that? Thank you so much. One of the producers corrected me on that. But let's take a look. You might see a familiar face.
You didn't even show up at a charity event that was benefiting education. But guess what? The night before, she was out giving expensive Christmas gifts, eh? So, you know, seriously, you have time to give to the rich people, but you don't have time for everybody else? Lisa J don't love the kids. So listen, honey, everybody loves a fun diva moment, but nobody likes
I love a good read, honey. Please welcome Ernestine Johnson Morrison.
Yes. Yes. Hey, boo.
Oh, my goodness.
Hello, my dear. Look at you, babe.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Good. How are you?
Excellent.
I'm doing nice.
You always look so amazing.
So do you.
Thank you.
I got you, baby. Ladies.
I got you, baby.
There you go.
Thank
make sure
you.
You're comfortable. There you go. How you doing, pumpkin?
Oh, I'm so good.
Hip-hop holiday. My God. Speaking of holidays, what did you do for Thanksgiving? Are you ready for Christmas?
I am ready for Christmas. You know, for Thanksgiving, my husband and I, we cooked together. We went to Terry Vaughn's house.
And
we
did.
We spent it here in Atlanta. We decided not to go home to L.A., so we spent it with friends. And we ate good, so I've been in the gym the last couple days.
You look
days.
Great.
Let me tell you.
Great.
I worked
Thank
out
you.
Twice yesterday just to try to combat some
Listen,
of the calories.
I get on Instagram and see her arms, and I'm like, oh, God.
Oh, well,
gym.
Thank you.
But you know she's been swimming for life.
For life.
So don't feel bad.
Right. It's all good. So now you are the thank you. I appreciate the compliment.
You're welcome.
You're the executive producer of this film.
Yes.
Or may just step outside of the scene and get behind the scene. You like that?
You know, as an actress, we don't always see the other side of the camera. We don't know all the ins and outs, and I thought it was really important for me to know all sides of the camera. And also, you don't always get the roles you want, and your peers don't always get the roles you want. So I knew I was in a financial position to help some filmmakers who we all know and love, Nina Holiday, Terry Vaughn, and Cassie Beatles.
Yes.
And I think that a lot of the times when it comes to black filmmakers, we don't have access to capital like other filmmakers do. And I knew that I had the capital, and I'm like, why not partner with black women who are trailblazing and making films and shooting films right here in Georgia and casting Atlanta actors. So that's how that came about.
I love it.
Yes.
So if I had to challenge you, would you prefer to be talent or would you prefer to be an executive producer?
You know, now that I've dabbled in a little bit of an executive producer hat, it's like, I love being the boss. I'm bossy.
Yes.
So I like to do both. I'm trying to Tyler Perry it, Oprah it. I want to be the producer and acting.
Good.
I want to create my own films that I star in.
Yeah.
What was
the
challenge there for you?
You know, I didn't realize that everything in a film or a project has a price tag attached to it. So looking at everything as a financier,
the
I'm
budget.
Like, whoa, how much did that prop cost?
Right.
it just, the challenge is like, wow, everything has a price tag.
Yeah.
You see that, now as an actor, you don't think about that. You're like, know my lines, I'm showing up. But as a producer, you're like, all right, what's this gonna cost?
Oh, you know, I know you were attracted to this project because of Nina Holiday, and you
Absolutely.
Actually had the capital, but what is it like to see fellow actors like our sister, Trina Braxton, and being able to see their dreams come true? Because once you come on this side of the lens, you know exactly what they're going through a scene.
Yep.
Does that give you, I think, a little bit more, is it more advantageous for you having spent time on the other side?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I was really so elated sitting in the chair, had my executive producer chair.
Did
I was really excited about it. I was like, make sure you get a picture. But to see the actors that we had in the film, just to know what that journey is, like getting the call and saying you got the part, to know that I just had a small part of being that vessel was really, really amazing for me.
Yes.
What do you want the audience to take away? What do you want the experience to be for the audience watching Hip Hop Holiday?
Well, it's a fun movie. We want people to feel cheerful, you know? I know Cass wrote it. It's fun. It's funny. It's starring a chocolate woman, Taronda Jones from Empire.
Yes.
You know, we wanted people to see like a lead actress who was chocolate skinned and who was voluptuous and curvy and really just changed.
Who's super funny, by the way.
Who's super talented and super funny. She did an amazing job. Shout out to Taronda.
Yeah.
But that's what we want people to see. We want you to look at the screen and see women who look like you.
Yeah.
And we want you to feel cheery and happy, and it's a love story.
Yes. I know you gave the money, but how much creative input did you have?
You know, I actually got to have a little, they gave me a little bit of creative input.
Okay.
I helped with the casting. So Safari's role, we were looking all over for that specific role for Safari. And I also made sure that part of the film was filmed in my building, the Legacy Center.
Really?
Yes.
Just put it on.
Money.
Right.
How you keep it in.
The Legacy Center.
Right.
Right.
So what was it like to cast Tyrande, and why did you think that she was so perfect for the role?
So I think when Terry and Cass created it specifically for Tyrande.
Oh, good. Mm.
Tyrande and I worked with Terry on Angrily Ever After. That was also on BET. And I know Terry's creative juices got to go, and she's like, I want to use Tyrande and really highlight her and her talent outside of Empire and really have her be the lead and allow her to shine. So. It was a package that came together.
Good. Well, that's so awesome. Well, it's always a pleasure having you down to the circle.
Really is.
Please be sure to follow her. She has amazing things going on. Mrs. Ernestine Morrison on Instagram.
All right, guys. But guess what? If you're staying around for the whole entire hour, we're going to take Ernestine to the table. You don't want to miss it. And the conversations, of course, always continue on all social media platforms at Sister Circle TV.
Yay. Awesome.
Yes, honey, you just gonna go ahead and eat all the
cookies. Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Of course, we are at the table with the amazingly talented and gifted Ernestine Johnson Morrison.
Thank you.
And boys, yes.
Radiant.
Right.
Thank you.
Yes.
Tell me more.
Girl, you're just fine.
Yes.
Yeah, it's just amazing to see, and I have to say, I enjoyed being on Hip Hop Holiday. I love Nina Holiday, period.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And everyone involved.
Job.
Oh my gosh. Thank you.
Parents did it.
But tell us about the platform that you created for content creators, for women of color and people of color to showcase their projects.
Yes, Greenlit ATL. I'm super, super proud of it. I started it in January of 2019, so we're coming up on a year. Mm-hmm. It's a social mixer for creatives, for industry professionals, actors, producers, directors, writers, content creators. And you know, Atlanta's the home of the networking event, but it's networking with a purpose, and we screen short content for filmmakers. I interview the filmmakers and ask them about the interview process in front of our live audience. But the great thing about Greenlit is we offer tangible tools and resources, so writers' courses, directors' courses, producers' courses, so you have something to take away.
Oh, that's awesome.
That's good.
So,
amazing.
Yes. That's good. So, I mean, did you feel like you had to start it because there was like a void there?
I feel like in Atlanta and Georgia specifically, being that we are this film hub now, everyone's trying to smooge and rub elbows and figure out how to network. And you go to these events, but it's kind of hard to touch people. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to create a space where you can actually touch Terry J. Vaughn. You can actually touch the Will Packers of the world and the directors and the producers who are out here really looking for new talent. Mm-hmm. And I created this hub, and it's a really amazing community, and it's really dope.
Good. Well, I just adore you, Ernestine. And I adore you as an actress and poet.
Thank
and so
you.
Many other things that are just of you creatively. But I also adore the fact that you're this amazing businesswoman and you're very, very smart. I like smart people.
Thank you.
So what I want to do is get your take on, child.
Ooh, here we go.
I want to get your take, okay, Ben, on this Gabrielle Union situation, child. The fact that they fired her from America's Got Talent, you know, we all know that it's very hard to navigate in this industry as women in general. Mm-hmm. What are your thoughts on this entire situation?
Well, first of all, I commend Gabrielle Union for taking a stance and using her platform, because we talk about black women all the time. We talk about LGBTQ. We talk about brown women. We talk about disabled people and having a voice, and I'm glad that she's using her voice. But in the spirit of Greenlit ATL, which our motto is create, don't wait, one of the best things Gabrielle Union can do now is create her own. She has a tenure, she's seasoned, she's learned, she's soaked up the game. Now it's time for her to go create something that she very well have the resources to do.
She sure could. That is a very good point. Yes.
Absolutely.
She could create her own America's Got Talent.
Absolutely.
She really can.
Create, don't wait.
She's got it. The talent, she's got the wherewithal.
She has the resources.
The connections, she has everything.
The biggest power move she can do right now is say thank you. I'm still going to use my voice to uplift people in marginalized communities and black women and LGBT. I'm going to do all of that, but I'm also going to create my own platform.
Yeah.
And that's what we did with Greenlit.
Yes.
And speaking of Greenlit, what does it mean to you to provide a place for production? And will the Legacy Center invest in production?
Yes, absolutely. So Greenlit ATL, it started off as a monthly networking event. It's the first Thursday of every month. So we'll be in Atlanta this Thursday, December 5th.
So you go across the country?
No, it's in Atlanta now, but we will have Greenlit LA, Greenlit New York, and Greenlit Chicago.
That's
but now,
awesome.
Greenlit is expanding into an entire media company, and is now going to be housed at the Legacy Center, which is my husband and I's building that we're launching in January.
Yes.
So it'll be a whole media company where we will invest in films, and we'll have people shadow and learn the filmmaking process, you know what I mean? On the camera and behind the camera.
That is so good. When I tell you, I like that, right?
part. That investment part has got my ears perked up.
We don't have access to capital like other. Yes, let's talk.
Let's do it.
I like a good return on my investment.
Right, ROI.
But can you talk us through that whole investment process from inception to conception to fruition? Like, how does that work?
What is the return on the investment?
Well, you know, this was my absolute first time, so it was a learning experience. And of course, I invested with my sisters, my partners, Nina Holiday, Terry and Cass, who are doing such phenomenal work.
Love them.
So when the opportunity was presented to me, I'm like, I can actually use this as a learning process, and I can learn as an actress and learn what it is to be an executive producer. So really, it was just cutting the check and getting with an amazing line producer and making sure everything checked out and make sure the set looked amazing and the actors felt comfortable and the crew felt comfortable. So
Ernestine, to ensure that all of this happens, like the set and everything being amazing, is it difficult trying to get the proper funding for these projects and for these, you know, these different productions that you guys put on?
Absolutely. I mean, I have so many friends and peers that have a slate of films just waiting. Mm-hmm. I mean, amazing projects just sitting because they don't have the access to the capital. Mm-hmm. And I think us as Black women and Black people who do have access to capital, it is our duty and our due diligence to, like, hey, sister, you got a project? All right, I got some funding. Let's go. Let's do this thing. Because we don't have the same resources and access like other filmmakers.
Well, what advice do you have for that person who's just starting out, or that whether it's behind the scenes or that actor that wants to come and hobnob, do they bring their resume there, or is that doing too much? Like, so what should they do?
Or do they buy a billboard, honey? Got time to
If they sign the billboard money, they can bring it to the movie.
Right. Yeah, because that's important. What's that first step for that person trying to get into the business, but they just don't know how? Yeah.
Here's what I will say, and this is, again, in the spirit of Greenlit ATL, create, don't wait. If you have a camera phone, and you know how to direct, and I know how to produce, and you know how to act, and you know how to write, there is no reason why we're still waiting on somebody to give us the green light. We have all the tools and resources. That's why it's important to build your village to put yourself in position and give yourself the green light on all
this. And be open to working relationships. Yes. That's the thing. We have to be open to work together. Yes. That has been like a thorn in our side for so long. Yes. Like, it's my project, girl. It's going out.
Right, collaboration.
Let's come together.
Collaboration.
It's my project, girl. But we thank you so much.
Look how God is using you,
and I'm just so happy that you've come and shown everybody the talent that you already have been exhibiting all over this world. Thank you so much. Continue success on everything. Please be sure to follow her on Instagram at Mrs. Ernestine Morrison to keep up with everything that she has going on in the production world.